So I don't know about you, but personally, I really do not like this default footer that ActiveCampaign adds to your emails. So over here, then there's suddenly some text centered in the middle of the email while my email here is on the left. And then it says send to, and then the email address, the unsubscribe link, and then the sender address of that email, so your address. So the unsubscribe link and the address, they have to be in there. There's no way around that. But you can change how this looks, and you can also add some text basically around it. So let me show you what I'm doing. So over here, I have an email, right? So this is the email that I previewed, and then this came out with this default footer over here. You can also see a little preview over here. But now what we can do is we can basically write our own footer, and then the default footer will just disappear. So this is the text that I wrote. This is the text that I'm using right now. So then here it says, unsubscribe if you don't want to receive my emails about growing your business with marketing automation anymore. I've crafted this email with a lot of passion while working remotely in Europe. My business address is dot, dot, dot. So I think this is much nicer. I will also design it a bit. You'll see that in a bit. But I think that's much nicer than, for example, this over here. Now, then there's two things we need to do. So over here, we need to include the unsubscribe link for the unsubscribe text. So then over here we go to link, and then the problem here is that I cannot just go here to your website and then put in like a random unsubscribe link, because then ActiveCampaign, they don't recognize that you included an unsubscribe link, and then it will still display the default footer. So what you need to do is you need to go over to the personalization tags, and then you need this one over here. So this is your variable, you could say, like your personalization tag for the unsubscribe link. You can also see here a preview of this, and then ActiveCampaign will dynamically generate that unsubscribe link for you. So I copy this over here, and then what I like to do is I have a plain text editor. I paste this in this over here. I copy it again just to get rid of any markup, any that might be on this page. And then I go back over to my email and I paste it in here, click here, okay. So okay, then you see this over here. And then it's basically the same thing with the address. I could not just type my address in here. I also need a personalization tag for that. So over here, I look for address. And then over here, you see here, sender info, single line. And then I can copy this and I edit again here in my editor just to make sure there's no markup or design elements in it. And I paste it again in here. And I also want to make this a little bit smaller, because I think it's like, it should still be readable, right? But it's not like the main topic of that email. So then over here, I preview this again. I will quickly delete this over here. I click here, send test. And then I preview this, go over here. And then right now you see that the default footer is gone. And right now we have this text over here. So dynamically it inserted that unsubscribe page. So boom, we go over here. And it also dynamically inserted the address over here. So I think much, much, much nicer, right? But then it might be a little bit annoying if you have this in all of your emails. And then maybe you want to change that unsubscribe text or that default footer, right? And it could be really lots of work. So what I recommend doing then is that you set up a message variable for the unsubscribe text. So you go over here to campaigns, to manage variables, and then over here I created one. So you can see here that it's called unsubscribe. If you click here edit, then you see over here we have that exact same text as that we have over here. So right now, what is so great about this is that in my email, I can just say here, okay, unsubscribe percent. And now if I delete this one over here and I preview this again, then you will also see that it shows up this text over here instead of that default footer. So I personally think that's the best approach. So create a new variable, give the name, it doesn't matter so much. Then the personalization tag you want to use inside your emails. So that's this thing you use over here, right? And then the lists you want to use it for. So if you want, you can also use different unsubscribe text for different lists. And then over here, you just style your footer. And then you really want to make sure again that you include this personalization tag for the unsubscribe link. and also the personalization tag for the sender info. So I hope that it was helpful. One more thing, what I think might also be really cool is you can also change the destination of this dynamic unsubscribe link. So if I click this over here, you saw that we go over to this page. So this is my own custom unsubscribe page, basically to collect some more info. If you want to learn how that is done, then be sure to watch this tutorial over here. And then I'll also show you how you can change that inside your emails. And if you have any other questions, just let me know in the comments below.